So now class 9, we have studied in Happy Prince that the swallow was helping the Happy Prince. How the swallow was helping the Happy Prince? Yes, by picking up the various, you can say, embellishments and to be given it to different persons. So what was the three things that he has given till now, the Happy Prince? First of all, the ruby. Okay, then afterwards he has given one of the sapphire to the playwright. Okay, why he has given the sapphire to the playwright? He was sitting in cold. He did not have any money in order to eat and in order to kindle some fire in the room, and ultimately he was feeling very cold and he was unable to write. Oh, sorry, unable to complete his play. Then afterwards, the second sapphire. Because she was afraid that her father would beat her. But then after, even after that, Happy Prince, when he was not able to see the world, okay, the swallow turned out on your face. Swallow turned out to be his eyes. She was flying, the swallow was flying over the city and was finding the misery of the people and was conveying it to the Happy Prince. So the Happy Prince came to know that under the arch, two children were sitting. They were clinging, or they were clinging their arms around each other. Why? Because they did not have any clothes to keep themselves warm. So such is the poor condition. And the swallow has also told the Happy Prince that he has also seen the wide gap between the rich and the poor. Wide gap between the rich and the poor. So what is the gap between the rich and the poor? That is, the richer, they were busy in merrymaking, they were enjoying, and moreover, the poor, they were waiting outside at the gates of the rich people in order to wait for food. So next, let us see how the Happy Prince will help them. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. So the swallow, he has flown back to the Happy Prince and told what he has seen. So the Happy Prince, again, he was deeply moved by those persons who were flying there. I am covered with fine gold. You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. Now the Happy Prince, he was actually had not suffered in his entire life from suffering from sorrow. So he did not know how to solve it, but he knew one thing, that gold make people happy. Because he knew that gold was costly, and after selling these sheets of gold, they can earn money, they can get money. So what he has told, you must take it off leaf by leaf. He said, please take each leaf off my dress, which is making my dress. Take this leaf off one by one, and ultimately you will give it to the different persons who are suffering. So leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off, till the Happy Prince looked quite dull and gray. So leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off. So after means each and every day, the swallow was flying over the city. He was looking at the misery of the people who were suffering, and he was translating the same thing to that of the Happy Prince. And the Happy Prince, who comes to know about the suffering of the people, and his heart was so deeply moved by it that he has told the swallow, pick one sheet and give to that person, pick one sheet, give to another. And in this manner, all the gold sheets which were covering his body, they were given. And leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's faces grew rosier. Rosier here signifies happiness. And they laughed and played in the street. We have bread now, they cried. So when the swallow was giving or dropping leaf by leaf to the different persons, Then what happened? Then the people, they were quite happy as they were, the children, they were laughing a lot because earlier they did not have anything to eat. But now their faces, they have turned out to be bright. Why? It is just because of the reason that they feel that now we have food to eat. We have bread now. Now they have food to eat and they were crying in happiness. It's not crying, shedding out tears, means shouting. Then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. So after that, what happened? Snow came, and after the snow came the frost. Okay. So what happened? Then it was snowy season. Okay. Then snow came the frost. That were not at all to be the favorable season for the swallow. The streets looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and the little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. So the streets, looking as if they were made of silver. Why the streets, they were looking as if they were made up of silver? Because they were covered with snow. They have turned out to be slippery too. Everybody went about in furs. All the people, they were covering their bodies in cozy furs in order to keep themselves warm. And the little boys wore scarlet, right, red colored caps and skated on the ice. Okay. And the young boys, they were skating on the ice. It was a time period of full of enjoyment and merriment for the young boys. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder. So the poor little swallow, what happened? He grew colder and colder because he was not able to cope up with this kind of weather. Okay. But he would not leave the prince, but he so committed to his goodness that he was not able to leave the king, happy prince. He was sitting at the foot of the happy prince. Although the swallow has turned out to be weak also because of cold, he's not able to fly, but still he was not leaving the happy prince. And he has finally dropped the idea of going to Egypt. So he picked up crumbs. Sorry, he loved him too well. And moreover, why the swallow was not leaving the happy prince? Because he loved him a lot. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. He was not able to move about and in order to get his food. So, and when the baker, nearby some baker shop was there, when the baker shop is closed, he used to go there and would pick up what? And he would pick up crumbs of bread in order to eat, in order to, and how to keep himself warm? He was flapping the wings. By flapping the wings, he was able to trap some air in it so that this will make him cozy and would feel little bit soft. But at last, he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. But now his strength was declining day by day, and the swallow knew now that it is time for him to say goodbye to this world. He is going to die, right? So, but still he had enough that much strength so that he could fly and could sit on the shoulders of happy prince. "Goodbye, dear prince," he murmured, spoke in a very low voice, not able to speak louder. "Will you let me kiss your hand?" And he said, "I'm going to die, but before that, I want to kiss your hand," because he loved the happy prince a lot. "I'm glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little swallow," said the prince. "You have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on my lips, for I love you." So the happy prince said, happy prince did not understand what his goodbye means, because he did not have any strength, the swallow. But the happy prince thought that he is now planning to go to Egypt. He said, "Finally, you have made up your mind that you are going to, that you are going to Egypt. That's a great idea." And now he was thankful to the swallow because he has spared some time. He stayed with the happy prince for quite a long time. And he said, "Really, I'm grateful, thankful to you. And for that, I have no words how to thank you. But rather than kissing on my hand, you can kiss me on my lips because I really love you. So it is not It is not to Egypt that I am going, said the swallow. I am going to the house of death, and death is the brother of sleep, is he not? So see what how deep thoughts he has explained here. He said, it is not to Egypt I am going. I am not going to Egypt. Okay, but where I am going? I am going to the house of death. And for death, death is the brother of sleep. It means when the person is going near death, he has to sleep for a long time. Okay, he has to sleep for a long time. Okay, so. And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. And what happened? And he kissed the happy prince and finally he was lying on the in the foot feet of the happy prince. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue as if something had broken. As soon as the swallow was dead, at the same moment, a crack, sound of a crack was said that something has broken. It was felt inside the happy prince. What was that? What you can think? What is that? Breaking of his heart, yes. The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right in two. Okay, it means that the lead, that the heart which was made up of lead, it has broken it into two pieces now. And it certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. And what it was? It was really a hard frost. Means because why it was hard? Because it led to the death of the two great, great you can say beings. Okay, one in the form of swallow and the another in the form of happy prince. Because they both were very loving, caring, as well as having generous attitude, showing selfless love towards others. So this is the end. This was really a dreadful hard frost. Why? Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in the company with the two town councillors. So the next morning, what happened? The mayor was coming. He was coming to the square. Okay, where he was? He was in the company of two councillors. You know that the mayor, he was taking a round of the city, that how my city looks, what amendments, what changes needs to be done. And he was not alone. He was accompanied by his two councillors. Okay. Heaven, sit properly, Vatsal. Tell him to sit properly. So, not feeling well? Not feeling well? Just go and drink water. So, as they passed the column, he looked up at the statue. Dear me. How shabby the happy prince looks, he said. Now, when they passed through that tall column, they looked at the statue of the happy prince and they said, how shabby it looks. Why it was looking shabby? Because all the gold, yes, it has been gone. Okay. He knew, and the eyes were no longer to be seen, and the sword hilt, it has also tarnished with the passage of time. How shabby indeed, cried the town council. So you know that the subordinates, they will definitely say yes to what their master is saying. Yes, they also asserted the same thing. Yes, how shabby it looks. Okay, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. So they agreed with the mayor that this statue, it is diminishing the beauty of the town, beauty of the city, and they have gone up in order to have a close look of the statue. The ruby has fallen out of his sword, his eyes are gone, and he is golden no longer. So what has happened? Yet the ruby has fallen out of the sword, which was given to whom? To the seamstress. And the two eyes of sapphires are gone. The two sapphires were one to the playwright and another to the match girl. Okay, and in fact, he is a better than a beggar. And see what comment he has gone. Nobody has seen that why they have gone. Okay, nobody was able to find out the reason that why it has gone. But ultimately what has happened? It was, they have just looked at the outer beauty. But what is actual beauty? Beauty is the beauty of the soul. Don't we always give importance to the displaying beauty, but that is not so important. But only the good qualities, they are always admired, right? the person is always acknowledged for his good qualities, right? So, little better than a beggar, said the two counselors. So what he said, that you are really, he said little better means that than the beggar. He's just looking like a beggar. So we need not to let this statue stand for a longer time here. Okay, so they thought to replace it and to demolish it. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet. And they saw that, Mir saw that at his feet, a dead bird was also there. It means that no one was taking care of this piece of statue. So we must really issue a proclamation. Proclamation means law, that birds are not to be allowed to die here. And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. Okay, and he said that we will make a law here that no one is going to die here. So see what kind of proclamation law the mayor was making, that no one should be allowed to die here. So is there any time for to be dead, or is there any place to be dead? It is not in the hands of a person. It is only in the hands of God, right? So finally, and the town clerk made a note of the suggestion, and the town clerk made a note of suggestion in his diary where he has to, where he is making his to-do list, what to do and how to be done. So they pulled down the statue of the happy prince, as he is no longer beautiful and he is no longer useful, said the art professor of the university. So it means that the king, before doing anything, he is taken into consideration the advice as well as suggestions of the experts also. And the art professor, he has also seen it. And he said this, the statue of the happy prince, it is no longer beautiful and it is no longer useful now. So they pulled down the statue of the happy prince, as he is no longer beautiful. Then they melted the statue in the furnace. Then it has to be disposed of. So as it was made up of metal, so what they have to do, they have to melt it down. What a strange thing, said the overseer of the workmen at the foundry. Okay, foundry means that place where it is melted. Okay, so what a strange thing, said the overseer, means the main person of that foundry. He said that it is a very strange thing. This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace, that this heart which is made up of lead, it won't melt up in this furnace. We must throw it away. So they threw it on a dust heap where the dead swallow was also lying. Okay, so what they have done, they have thrown it on the dust heap where the dead swallow was lying. So it was thrown into the trash where everything was there. So bring me the two most precious things in the city of God, said God. So now the scene has been shifted to heaven, where the God dwells, lives. So what the God has said, God has ordered his angels that go to earth and bring the two most beautiful things from there. And the angel brought him the leaden heart and the dead bird. So from the whole earth, they have not found the costly things, but what they have found, they have found that the two most beautiful things on the earth are only the dead swallow as well as the leaden heart of the happy prince. You have rightly chosen. Even God said, yes, you have chosen right. These are actually the two most beautiful things. Okay. For in my garden of paradise, this little bird shall sing forevermore. And in my city of gold, the happy prince shall praise me. And they were given special places in the heaven and special places in the house of God. Happy prince always stayed there with the God in order to praise him. And ultimately, the swallow was there to sing in the garden of God. So what ultimately this chapter displays? This chapter displays the inner beauty. Okay? And that is, the inner beauty is important than any other kind of beauty. Okay? So this chapter, it also bringing this chapter, the theme of this chapter or the message of this chapter, it is also standing true in the present world also, where people, they are busy or they are always giving importance to their showy world. Okay, they are giving importance to their showy world, right? So ultimately what happens because of this, people they used to, for example, they use lot of social media, they brag about of their accomplishments. Okay, but that was not reality. That was just a virtual platform. What is the actual accomplishment in which you enhance your personality, in which you attain something? Okay, so like we beautify our body with different kind of ornaments, with different kind of things. But how can we beautify our personality? How can we enhance our character? It is by the accomplishments that we have done. Okay, that what we have achieved in our life. So it is very difficult to make your personality glitter. It is very difficult to make your personality shine. So this message is also stands true in the present time when people are not giving much importance to the beauty of soul. They are only busy in you can say beautifying their bodies. But what God admires, selfless love. Okay, selfless love, generous attitude, kind attitude, to have feeling behavior towards other. And those persons who don't have this kind of feeling behavior for others or empathetic feeling. Empathetic feeling means, empathy means to sharing, you can say, or to understand the feelings of others. Those who have this kind of feeling, they always find a place in the house of God. And they never feel, you can say, to be, although on the earth, see, the happy prince was not at all acknowledged. He was not no longer considered to be beautiful when his, you can say, all the gold has gone and all the ornaments, they have gone from his statue. But ultimately, even his heart, which was broken into two pieces, and which was made up of lead, and lead is not a costly thing, okay, and which is very heavy, still they are considered to be beautiful. It means that your soul should be attractive towards the feelings of others. Okay, it should act as a magnet to feel, though, to have the feelings of others, to understand what other people feel, and you should always extend a helping hand towards others. And only those people, they are all, only those kind of people, they are always admired in the house of God, right? In the house of God. So this is what the chapter is all about. Okay, so ultimately this chapter, it is giving us the idea that one should spread enough goodness so that goodness only prevails this earth. And it is only by the goodness that we spread that we will be able to make this earth a beautiful place to live. And only then our earth will be a great place to live. Right? Okay? Fine? Right? So any doubt if you have, you can ask. So I think Panika has sent a clap, means that she liked the chapter most. And even I think that this is the one of the most beautiful chapters. Okay, very heart touching, very good. Even Kingdom of Fools is full of, you can say, different kind of, you can say, good moral values. But this is emotional one, touching one, and it is delivering one of the best things. Okay, throughout the chapter, the author is, you can say, the author or the narrator is able to maintain the emotional touch with each and every dialogue. What he is writing, it is, you can say, it is dipped completely in emotions. And ultimately, what we are reading, we are feeling, yes, of course, this is true, right? So this is all about Happy Prince. And tomorrow we will discuss the question answers of the Happy Prince, okay? Okay, if we have 1 to 2 minutes, let us see. Why do the courtiers call the prince Happy Prince? Is he really happy, and why does he, what does he see all around him? Yes, Peta. Your name? Halavni. Yes. But we, okay. So the courtiers, they call the happy prince as happy prince, as he lived in a only peaceful and happy environment. When he was alive, sorrow was not allowed to enter his palace, and he has never encountered suffering and misery in his entire life. He did not know what actually sorrow and weeping is, and he has never come to know how the people feel when they are suffering from this kind of situation. So is he really happy? Actually, he was actually not happy. It is only the situation that has made happy, as he has never encountered sorrow in his life, or never faced any kind of sorrow in his life. And what does he see all around him when he was dead? Through the eyes of swallow, what he has seen, only misery. He has seen that people are suffering from various kind of problems. They don't have money, they don't have food to eat. And in this manner, his heart was deeply moved and he wanted to help those people. And in this, you can say regard, he has given all his beautiful or all his embellishments that were covering his body to the different people. Right? So that's all for today. And tomorrow we will continue the discussion of this chapter. Okay? So you can write down this question in your notebooks.